Hola amigos, bienvenidos. Hi friends, and welcome back to another great lesson on the Language Tutor. Well, the last time we were together, I taught you some grammar concepts using indirect object pronouns, direct object pronouns, reflexive, all of that, when you have other verbs involved. Okay, so today's lesson is going to be a short, easy modification to that last episode. All right, so let's jump right into it. Now, first of all, in the last episode, I showed you some examples. The first one we showed you was using the word una carta, and I showed you this sentence. La voy a mandar. La voy a mandar. Okay, so it, I am going to send. Now, we were referring to una carta, a letter. So because it was feminine, we use la as the direct object pronoun. And so we're saying it, I'm going to send. But that's why we use la, because it's referring to a feminine object, which is una carta. All right, and we also used lo necesita limpiar. Okay, the lo was referring to any kind of masculine object, and it, he needs or she needs to clean. Okay, and then we also use this one, nos vamos a poner la ropa. To ourselves, we're going to put on the clothes. So we're going to put on our clothes and get ready. All right. Now, what I'm going to do in this lesson is show you a different way to do it. And it's really simple, because we just simply take that word that we, you know, the direct object pronoun or the reflexive pronoun, whatever, we take it and put it in a different place. That's it. So let's put our first example up really quick. La voy a mandar. We're talking about una carta. It, I'm going to send. The other way we can do this is to take the la and move it to the verb at the end, mandar, and actually attach it to the verb and make it part of the word. Voy a mandarla. Voy a mandarla. It becomes a part of the verb. It's a really interesting way to do things. So we can say la voy a mandar or voy a mandarla. Either one. It's really cool. But just make a note that it has to be attached to and part of the word. Okay, so let's look at the next one that we did. Lo necesita limpiar. It, he needs to clean, or she needs to clean, or maybe even the usted form can be necesita. But let's just go with he or she right now. The other way we can do it is to take lo and move it to limpiar and attach it to the verb. And so you get this, necesita limpiarlo, necesita limpiarlo. So summary, you can say lo necesita limpiar or necesita limpiarlo. Either one works good. Now let's go back to that third example. Nos vamos a poner la ropa. What we can do is take the nos, move it to poner, and you're probably guessing it already. Put it at the end of the verb and attach it to the verb. So this is what we get. Vamos a ponernos la ropa. It's a mouthful of ours, isn't it? Vamos a ponernos la ropa. So we can say, nos vamos a poner la ropa, or we can say, vamos a ponernos la ropa. Either one. And guys, that's it. It's a really cool, quick, easy grammar structure that you can bring into your conversation right now. Okay, so I encourage you to practice that. Anytime you get that verb and then an infinitive verb also with it, you know, do different ways to practice that infinitive verb, putting the object pronoun or the reflexive pronoun at the end or at the beginning. You can do it both ways. Either way, practice all you can. I'll see you next time on The Language Tutor. Friends, thanks for watching The Language Tutor. If you have a question for me, feel free to leave it in the comment section below the video. And please click subscribe and the notification bell so that you'll never miss any of our language lessons.